here I stand, with my presentation soon at hand. Shall read from the 1969 release from Sandy Denny and Fairport Convention. Legion Leaf is the album. The song Tam Lin in the background with Sandy on vocals. We shall read What Lies Within from this classic recording. The illustrations and the stories beneath, as it were. Paysaggers. Paysagging, an Easter custom in the northwest of England, uses the egg as a symbol of the springtime rebirth of life. Another symbolic rebirth depiction, the mummers play, is sometimes performed by the paysaggers as they go a-begging for eggs. These plays involve usually a hero fighting evil, being killed and then being revived by a mock physician. The drawing shows paysaggers from the Kirkby Stephen era, rather area, 1894. Padstow Hobby Horse. At midnight on the eve of May Day, the Padstow Hobby Horse may be seen going round the houses of the town with its attendants of men and women dressed as sailors, singing songs of joy at the coming of summer. The hobby horse is actually a man underneath a covered hoop, topped by a grotesque head with a long pointed cap. In the final dance, the death of the horse is depicted. The next day, a second procession visits houses, inviting elves, rather. Francis James Child. It is largely thanks to Professor Francis James Child, 1825 to 1896, that so many British ballads are known to us today. Born in Boston, Child came to England as the result of his studies, were Scottish and English popular ballads, or English and Scottish popular ballads. The definitive collection, never to be superseded, before Child, accurate editions of ballad text were few and far between. The Bury Man. The Bury Man, a boy in white flannel covered with burrs from the wild burdock, can be seen at the annual fair on the second Friday in August at South Queensbury at West Lothian. He also has a floral headdress and carries flower-decked staves. He tours the town in silence. He cannot and must not be drawn into speech. The custom is said to have originated with the Scottish King Malcolm, who camouflaged himself in burrs to escape from the English. As you will travel with me on camera in full tune to my ale tankard, I shall refresh my throat before I move on to the second passage. Cecil Sharp. Cecil Sharp, 1859 to 1924, started to collect English folk songs and dances at the beginning of the century, and during 20 years, he noted nearly 5,000 song and dance tunes, 3,300 in England, and nearly 1,700 in the southern Appalachian mountains of America. Cecil Sharp House, center of the EFDSS, was erected in 1929 in Camden Town, London. In his memory, it is truly said of him that he restored to the English the songs and dances of their country. Broadside Cellar. Broadside Cellars were familiar figures in the streets from the early XV1 to the late XIX centuries. A broadside ballad was a printed sheet of verse falling historically and stylistically between the earlier folk ballad and the later development of the newspaper. George Wyatt and Friends. George Wyatt of West Parktree, Somerset, one of a vanishing breed of rural songsters who gleaned his knowledge of music from his father before him. Among the songs Cecil Sharp collected from him were Lord Randall, 40 Long Miles, and Welcome In Young Shepherds. Morris dancing. Morris dancing is one of the forms of Englishmen's ritual dance and has been practiced since time immemorial. The term Morris, referred to by country people, could mean mummers, sword or Morris dancing. It is considered generally to take two forms. The Northwest dance, usually in clogs on the Cotswolds. The original custom was to dance in the springtime, but it now takes place all the year round. The photograph shows the Banton Morris performing about 1900. Down among the dead men. Here's health to the king, and a lasting peace. To faction an end, to wealth increase. Come, let's drink it while we have breath, for there's no drinking after death. And he that will his health deny, down among the dead men, let him lie. John Dyer. And on the tombstone, in the illustration, the memory of Thomas Thatcher, a grenadier from the North Regiment Hans Militia, who died of a violent fever contracted by drinking small beer when hot on the 12th of May, 1764, aged 26 years. Hunting of the Wren. The wren, the smallest bird known to the Celtic peoples, play a big part in their folklore. Till recent times, the custom of wren hunting was followed by the Irish, rather in the Irish countryside, on St. Stephen's Day, 26th December. Men and boys of the parish would search the hedges for wrens to chase and kill. In remote areas, boys playing instruments plead for money for the burial of the wren. I will try to declare the tombstone's ingredients as far as the passage on the stone, if I can find it legible for my presentation. In grateful remembrance, this is part of Down Among the Dead Men, by the way, in grateful remembrance of whole universal good, to reward his comrades, this stone is placed here at their expense as a small testimony of their regard and concern. Here fleets in peace all amphitheater grenadier who caught his death by drinking cold small beer. Soldiers were wise from his untimely fall, and when your hot drink, strong or bone at all, this memorial being decayed was restored by the officers of Garrison in 1781 AD. An honest soldier never is forgot, whether he die by musket or by pot. This stone was placed by the Northampton Militia, Reuben Belief embodied, in Winchester on 26 April 1802, in configurance of the original stone being deported. I'm sure I've been slightly inaccurate with the pronunciation of some of these words. I will search the jacket for encores in the form of literature as we listen to Crazy Man Michael from the same LP. Join with me once again as we return to the table for another sip from the tankard. Your throat's been parched all day. Readings much unlike this. Once again, I shall read Hunting of the Wren. The Wren, the smallest bird known to the Celtic peoples, plays a big part in their folklore. Till recent times, the custom of wren hunting was followed in the Irish countryside on St. Stephen's Day, the 26th of December. Men and boys of the parish would search the hedges for wrens to chase and to kill. In remote areas, boys playing instruments plead for money for the burial of the wren. Down among the dead men, once again. Here's a health to the king and a lasting peace. To faction an end, to wealth increase. Come, let's drink it while we have breath, for there's no drinking after death. And he that will his health deny, down among the dead men, let him lie. Once again, the Padstow hobby horse. At midnight on the eve of May Day, the Padstow hobby horse may be seen going round the houses of the town with his attendants of men and women, dressed as sailors singing songs of joy at the coming of summer. The hobby horse is actually a man underneath in a covered hoof, topped by a grotesque head with a long pointed cap. In the final dance, the death of the horse is depicted, and the next day a second procession visits houses inviting all. This particular point, brothers and sisters, I shall close the liege and leave passage. Not till we meet again. And the traditional greetings once again, brothers and sisters. Have with me Steel Ice Band's first American release, Pleased to See the King. The vocals of Martin Carthy in the background on Boys of Bedlam. I shall read what is on the back, as it were. The Priory of St. Mary of Bethlehem at Bishop's Gate, founded in 1247, became the male lunatic asylum known as Bethlehem Hospital or Bedlam in 1547. In 1815, it was moved to Lambeth in the buildings now housing the Imperial War Museum, and in 1931 was moved to Beckenham in Kent. The Hospital of St. Mary Magdalene, Magdalen, was its female counterpart. During the 16th and 17th centuries, the Man in the Moon was depicted as a bent old man with a staff, leading a dog, carrying a thorn bush and a lantern. We shall speak now of the False Knight on the Road. The False Knight is the devil, and if the wee boy failed to answer his questions, he would lose his soul to the devil. We shall speak of the king. The wren traditionally symbolized winter and the robin summer. On False Knight in Pembrokeshire, where the song was collected, the wren was hunted and killed to symbolize the death of winter, and then placed in a garlanded box and taken from door to door. At each house, this song was sung, and the occupants asked to pay to see the dead wren with the words, "Pleased to see the king." For the remainder of this tune, I shall walk about with me staff with the representation of the Man in the Moon. And I will depict a bent old man with a staff leading an invisible dog or an invisible Alsatian carrying an invisible thorn bush and perhaps an invisible lantern. Join with me as we return to the mug for another coating, as it were.
Record, I don't even want to record.
Is it recording? It's all the way.
I want it to record though, crap.
Did you take crap? Did you take the other?
Under the porch. Let's get a close up under the porch. Oh, my goodness.
That's the best place for all the animals.
How come you don't clean that up? Do you like it? How come you don't clean it? That's the right way of it on film.
Yeah, that'll be funny. I'm trying to get in my youthful position here. I can still do it.
Or how about that? Did you ever do that game when you both put your feet like that?
I think so. That'll be good.
Playful.
It's like we're ready to smoke or something. We got those, what do they call it, Turkish rounds or something? Those old things from the 70s.
Oh, I learned that. Do that.
I don't know.
put ZZ plus KC.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's a little bit.
What quarter is
it? A quarter or something.
Okay. So I gotta put forever. You know how you used to do forever.
I should get a knife out and we can put that on the tree too.
Oh yeah.
Put the knife out and get money.
Just don't make me get up against the board.
The board?
Yeah.
Oh no.
Looks like a hat. Did you do that? Maybe I'm out of process if you can say that.
That's what she gets.
What color?
Orange.
Oh my god, ESPN is going. What's in this color?
Come on, let's look at the trailer because it's up for sale and they see this. And then they see that picture of like a homey kind of thing,
yeah.
Except for that threatening picture on the door. But ends up getting just their knees.
You know that little face you have that you always do? I'll put my eye on the ball. Uh-oh, I hope the kids don't come over.
Oh, that'd be more interesting.
That's what those two grown-up people do. Can we do it?
Well, I know. That would be more interesting. We'd get them all on tape. Margaret looking through the window or something. Can we do it too?
Huh? Oh, yeah, can we do it too? Put my name on there.
That would be better. Get it on tape. Or I could stand out on the front there. Hear ye, hear ye.
Talk ready, huh?
Yeah. Feet on the ground or something like that. See, it's the yellow screen when that happens.
When it blows?
Yeah.
Here.
Your duck, duck, goose or something.
Forever. Hey, that looks pretty good.
What's that?
Huh?
Is that a prelude?
Actually, you remember it. Traveling and then it would be 8, 9, and then, you know, that's how you would do it. Ha, 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 ha.
Because that's just from the thing of charts, so it's like 2 minutes.
All busted up and everything.
Oh, wait, I don't like that. Yeah, that's better. I wonder if it's still going. It is cool. The battery lasts it. Yay! The chalk episode. Miniature hopscotch. There's the culprit. Yeah. There's the evidence. Whoops. Our artwork class. I'll get Max on that. Call it. Angles. Wait, stand there. Let's get your shadow on it. Ooh.
Expecting Clint Eastwood to appear.
Okay. What is that? What's that?
Which one? Trying to find a pile of dog manure back here.
So. Oh, sure enough, there isn't. Oh.
The cable has been there for like 2 years, laying outside the. Soil.
Oh my gosh. I want that all lined up like a little soldier. Well, we could say there's so many areas for yourself.
Oh yeah.
Hey, you know what would be funny?
Yeah.
To stage a mock something, a finding something in there. You know what I mean?
Perhaps.
I mean, it looks, you know. See, it's eerie. There's your shadow on the door. What will we find?
Stole the idea from Geraldo Rivera.
Yeah, like the Al Capone thing.
Yes. Where are we headed?
And what a letdown that was.
What was in there?
Nothing. Just old nothing. Okay, Kurt Rivera.
My mom knows him.
Oh, she does?
She used to live where my mom works.
Wow.
By Ridge, where I used to live.
Oh, wow.
We shall go within, as it were, see what revealeth. Looks like something may be within. Observe my shadow.
menacing.
One side must be opened only.
Oh. Oh my God, scary. This is scary. Oh my God, what is that?
The band's and wasp nest.
Ew. Ew.
It was right up here. Last year.
Oh, you got it all clean.
Right here. I didn't want to disturb them when they were still living in it, so.
Oh my God, a lawnmower.
Oh heavens. They're a decent cocoon in here, I wonder. I think so.
Oh yeah. Ew.
Don't want to bother it.
Ew, I know.
Something interesting might come out of it.
What's really in that box on the bottom? Is that a body cut up?
Over there.
Yeah. Is that what really happened to Tim? Is that why his jacket is here?
Well, I gotta stand on the porch and try to get the paper again with my teeth in.
Tim didn't really leave his jacket. That's him in the box.
You are the one who lives next door.
Oh my God. Where is Tim really? Where is Tim? Oh my God, who's that? Don't say another word.
It must be my brother, the doctor.
Doctor who? Doctor of what?
He's in the basement painting.
Ooh. Who's that?
I don't know.
We'll find out. Shall we go discover the X-Files?
Perhaps.
Homemade.
Gallows.
Homemade gallows. Bottom box. Hear the slamming of the steel. Okay. What do you got?
Fungus.
My eye. Geek. Geek.
Here I stand with fungi in my hand.
Let me get the full view. How does a man stand with fungi in hand?
Now,
Hitler. What say ye? Do what? Do what? Get up, you Mason.
My what? I feel like a dilapidated cement man.
Have you had a hard day at work, cement man?
Oh, perhaps.
Is it trying to get that mess off the cement? Is that what got you?
Very well be.
Hard job. You didn't seem to have got it done. It's still on there, Cement Man. What are you going to do about it, Cement Man?
It remains to be in the four winds. Perhaps I'll come out by the light of the moon. Top coat. Floppy hats, and commence to the designated activity.
Sounds like it might work then, Cement Man.
Perhaps.
Perhaps?
But in the meantime, here I lay as though I was an abused Gandhi dancer. Who was served moose turd pie. I shall now assume the position.
Okay, Cement Man. Up and in. Get profile. Somebody go help him.
Nobody lays on cement like that.
The Cement Man does.
Yep.
People drive by, nobody cares that you're laying there passed out, Cement Man. People go on with their lives.
I'm afraid they do.
You see how long you lay there before somebody comes?
Drill the whole neighborhood.
Fire, fire, SOS. Man down, man down.
I feel like I'm part of Gulliver's Travels or something.
All right.
could proceed by saying, here I stand with my utility in my hand, but in this particular case, I shall proceed with the following. Greetings from Charles Baudelaire. 20 prose poems, as it were. I shall begin with Confidior of the Arts. How penetrating are the ends of days in autumn. Oh, penetrating to the point of grief. For there are certain delicious sensations whose vagueness does not exclude intensity, and no point is sharper than that of the indefinite, rather the infinite. Oh, the vast delights of gazing fixedly, drowning one's glance in the immensity of sky and sea. Solitude, silence, incomparable chastity of the azure, a little sailing boat shuddering on the horizon, the paradigm, in its littleness and its isolation, of my irretrievable existence, monotonous melody of the surge. All these things reflect my thoughts, or I reflect theirs. For in the grandeur of reverie, the ego is soon lost. They think, as I say, but musically and picturesquely, without quibbling, without syllogism, without deduction. Nevertheless, these thoughts, whether formed within me, or projected from things, soon grow too intense. The energy which pleasure does not absorb creates a kind of unrest and a positive pain. My nerves, now excessively tense, transmit only wailing and sorrowful vibrations. And now the profundity of the sky perplexes. The limpid light exasperates me, the insensitiveness of the sea, the immobility of the sense, rather of the scene, revolting. Oh, must we suffer eternally, or flee eternally from all that is beautiful? Nature, unpitying enchantress, ever victorious rival, let me be. Leave off tempting my desires and my pride. The study of beauty is a jewel in which the artist cries out in terror for being vanquished. Get drunk. Aye. One should always be drunk. That's all that matters. That's our one imperative need, so as not to feel time's horrible burden that breaks our shoulders and bows you down. You must get drunk without ceasing. But with what? Or what with? wine, with poetry, or with virtue. As you choose, but get drunk. And if at some time on the steps of a palace, in the green grass of a ditch, in the bleak solitude of your room, you are waking up when drunkenness is already abated, ask the wind, the wave, the star, the clock, all that which bleeds, all that which grows, all that which rolls, all that which sinks, all that which speaks. Ask them what time it is, and the wind, the wave, the star, the bird, the clock will reply, it is time to get drunk, so that you may not be the martyred slaves of time. Get drunk, get drunk, and never pause for rest, with wine, with poetry, or with virtue. As you choose. The soup and the clouds. My little mad darling was giving me my dinner. And through the open window of the dining room, I was contemplating the moving architectures, rather architectures. Didn't I just say that? That God makes out of vapors. Those marvelous constructions of the impalpable. And I said to myself, in the midst of my meditation, all those phantasmagorica, rather phantasmagoria, are almost as beautiful as the eyes of my beloved. That monstrous little mad woman with the green eyes. Suddenly I received a violent blow on my back, and I heard a charming, raucous voice, a voice hysterical and as though made hoarse by brandy, the voice of my sweet little darling, who was saying, well, are you going to eat your soup or aren't you, you bloody dithering cloudmonger? Pause with me for contemplation. In the third person.
Oops, wait a minute, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
we meet again. The second part of the second passage, as it were. Another round, as it were, and so to speak. How much ado? It's not given to everyone to take a bath in the multitude. To enjoy the crowd is an art, and only that man can gorge himself with vitality at the expense of the human race. Whom in his cradle a fairy has inspired with love of the skies and of the mad, with hatred of the home and a passion for voyaging. Multitude, solitude, terms that to the active and fruitful poet are synonymous and interchangeable. A man who has, rather, a man who cannot. People, his solitude is no less incapable of being alone in a busy crowd. The poet enjoys the incomparable privilege that he can, at will, by either himself or another, like those wandering spirits that seek a body, he enters when he likes into the person of any man. For him alone, all is vacant, and if certain places seem to be closed to him, it is that. To his eyes, they are not worth the trouble of being visited. The solitary and pensive pedestrian derives a singular exhilaration from the universal, rather this universal communion. That man who can easily wed the crowd knows a feverish enjoyment which will be eternally denied to the egoist, shut up like a trunk, and to the lazy man imprisoned like a mollusk. The poet adopts as his own all the professions, all the joys, and all the miseries with which circumstance confronts him. What men call love is very meager, very restricted, and very feeble. Compared to this ineffable orgy, to this holy prostitution of the soul that abandons itself entirely, poetry and charity included, to the unexpected arrival, to the passing stranger. It is good occasionally to bring home to the happy people of this world, were it only in order to humiliate for a moment. I nearly began reading the French. Their inane pride, that there is a happiness superior to theirs, faster and more refined. The founders of colonies, the pastors of peoples, missionary priests, exiled to the ends of the earth, doubtless know something of this mysterious drunkenness. And in the heart of the vast family, which their genius has created for itself, they must laugh sometimes at those who pity them for their destiny that is so unquiet, and for their life that is so chaste, or chaste, whichever one prefers, without altering the meaning of the author's work.
hemisphere and a head of hair. I say a hemisphere and a head of hair. Long let me inhale deeply the odor of your hair. Into it plunge the whole of my face, like a thirsty man into the water of a spring. And wave it in my fingers, like a scented handkerchief, to shake memories into the air. If you could know all that I see, all that I feel, all that I hear in your hair, my soul floats upon perfumes as the souls of other men upon music. Your hair contains an entire dream, full of sails and masts. It contains vast seas whose soft monsoons bear me to delightful climates, where space is deeper and blue, where the atmosphere is perfumed with fruit, with foliage, and with human skin. In the ocean of your hair, I am shown brief visions of a port resounding with melancholy songs, of vigorous men of all nations and ships of all shapes, outlining their fine and complicated architectures against an immense sky where eternal heat languidly quivers. In the caresses of your hair, I recover the languor of long hours passed down a divan, rather divan. In the cabin of a fine ship, rocked by the imperceptible, surge of the port, between the flower pots and the refreshing water jugs, in the glowing fire grate of your hair, I inhale the odor of tobacco mingled with opium and sugar. In the night of your hair, I see the infinity of tropical azure resplendent. On the down banks of your hair, I inebriate myself with the mingled odors of tar, of musk, and of coconut. Long let me bite your heavy black tresses. When I gnaw your elastic and rebellious hair, it seems to me that I am eating memories. In this particular case, I will make an attempt to read the former passage, Get Drunk, in French, if I must so muster. Perhaps I don't have the opportunity. Oh, yes, I do. Perhaps on the opposite side of the page, as trends may dictate. In this particular case, I must swig from my tankard once again. Draw from me pipe. And I must briefly confer with Don Roberts for one brief moment. And liver as boo. Il faut etter to Joriver, Tautisluck. Sail unique question. For in the past century, the horrible for due attempts. The prize. Aleppo. At boo, Pnash, the Thierry Il Faut House. And ever since prevail. My dequai, divin, the post to a ver, to virtue, the voter guys, last to never is food. And so the hubbub.
Sebu de Chambre, Vu Vu Verville. La Versa, Deha, Demifri, Despartal. Demand is a bet. Alabu, let it toil. Alice, Ella Orgel. A tout, Zea Fruit. A tout, Zequik Women. A tout, Ellis Rule. A tout, Ellis Shante. A tout, Ellis Parley. Demand is Willie Harl. In a vest, Elevet, Levague, Latoil, Lassieu, Lahorg, the respondent.
Eris Bundle.
Ellis Her, Ellis Enever, Porinetri, Paulus Eclipse, Myrnalis Contempt, Eneveris Boo, Eneveris Boo, San Sess, Davin de Poissy, Gelliverdu de Volgeis.
Oh, all right, 20 minutes. Yay.
I understand that you have like amateur night over there. I've got an idea for an act. I wonder if you know you'd be interested. I have this presentation called Authentic Oddball Dialogue. And well, what would I do? Oh, well, I would. Sometimes I wear a beret or a stovepipe hat. And I would get out there and say things like, if you will now turn with me to the 75th passage of O'Halloran's canister, we can clearly state, you know, in the Book of Menudo that, you know, ever yet lay low with embedded manure and, you know, bring down the wind, and I'd sing Dillard the Buffalo. Oh, okay, no more examples, okay, you get the idea. Yeah, just, you know, off-the-wall humor and, come on in, Thursday nights, okay, give it a try. Yeah, because I would like to do my authentic oddball dialogue for a living, instead of being a dishwasher. Okay, then. Thursday night at 8 o'clock. Okay. All right, well, thanks a lot. Yeah. Your last name's Cole, C-O-L-E. Okay. All right, then. Take care. Residue all over this glass. Don't you do the dishes? It's filthy. I don't know, I went out to Utah, and 25 degrees below zero out there. I tell you, I gotta get the right windows. I don't have the right windows.
Wohin auch das Auge blicket, Mond heide ringsherum, Vogelsang und Snechte kricket, Eichen stehen hart und krumm. Wir sind die Korsoldaten und ziehen mit den Staaten.
Shall be at last, and will the people you doing?
Good.
Oh, you just lost $5? Okay. How you doing?
Good.
I already said that, didn't I?
Yeah.
Well, $5. Okay, here you go, man. How you doing?
Good.
What'll it be?
$5.
Oh, I just put in 10. How you doing?
Good.
It's going to rain today, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a lot tight. We need rain. You going to watch the Michigan State game?
Nah. Good.
Finally got cold, didn't it?
Yeah.
I kind of hear. I tell you here. My dad's name is Valentine.
Oh, really?
Valentine Dress.
Valentine what?
Valentine Dress.
Valentine Dress?
Dress.
Valentine Dress?
Valentine Dress.
Okay.
D-R-E-F-F-S. How you doing?
Good.
I see it might, see it might rain today, huh?
Yeah.
$5?
Yeah, $5. Oh.
Watch the big game tonight?
No, not tonight.
It's Michigan State and Notre Dame.
Yeah.
How much time do we got left?
Just 5 minutes.
you're taking a long time to fill a tank up.
Yeah.
Oh, I see my dad. Let me go get my dad.
Okay.
I can't find my dad. I have my dad's glasses on the whole time.
Oh.
I don't normally wear glasses, so my contacts look bad. I can't find my dad. I see my dad coming.
Oh, good.
Hello.
Hello.
What'll it be today?
$5.
$5? Okay. It sure is a nice day today, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. You come again now.
All right, thanks.
You're welcome. Where's my son?
He went that way.
That way?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You have a nice day.
Thank you.
You come back again now.
All righty.
You all set now?
Yeah.
Did my dad come out?
Yeah, he did.
Did he have his glasses?
Yeah, he
did. I was wearing his glasses by mistake.
Oh.
I wondered if I gave him his glasses back.
Yeah, you did.
Did he tell you that there was a Michigan State game on?
Yeah.
Notre Dame and Michigan State, big game today, $5?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Okay.
Jeez.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Valentine Drops.
Hi there.
This is my station.
Yeah?
I've ran the station since 1951.
Oh, okay.
I put in for my retirement and I wanted to keep it going. My son works here and he needs all new teeth put in, but we haven't got the money. $5?
Yeah.
Okay. Nice day today.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. Do you have any questions you want to ask me?
Yeah, why Why did your son have on your glasses?
Oh, he thought they were coconuts.
Oh.
Oh. That'll be $5.
All right, here you go. Thanks.
Any other questions, ma'am?
No, not today. Who do you think will win the big game?
Oh, I think the Waffle Spirits will win. I think Notre Dame and Michigan State playing today.
That's what I've heard.
Yeah. How many times have you heard that, ma'am?
Oh, a few.
Where's my suspenders? Maybe my son has my suspenders. You have a good day, ma'am.
Okay, you too.
Thank you.
Okay, that's it.
Okay. What?
31 years of age today.
What is today?
October
date?
The. What 11? Is today? The 12th.
No,
1998.
The 11th. Tomorrow's the
12th. Are you sure?
Yeah.
That's right. October 11th, 1998. And Kurt Cole sits here at 30 years of age, contemplating. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh.
10 minutes to 7.
10 minutes to 7 on a Sunday evening.
Dusk in the autumn, Whitmore Lake.
In Whitmore Lake, right. And there he sits.
And I suppose this is probably a winter's day where there's a big blizzard happening.
Yeah, it might be when we watch this.
I'm sure at some point.
Da 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 da. It's on the countdown. Let's just wait until it like goes off. 1 minute. I feel like it's New Year's Eve. Six, how did
that's
I do
that? That's when this could be played. Who knows?
Oh.
I'm a bit rusty today because of my job. I apologize. Nevertheless, relax.
Wow, this is a long minute, actually. I want to see what it does. It'll actually just cut off, I guess.
I hope it don't start over again and erase what we are.
No, it won't. It will cut off. It won't start over unless you rewind it.
It won't start recording backwards or anything, will it?
Uh-uh.
Like continuous record?
Nope.
Not that there is such a thing.
Mm-mm. It'll shut off. I'm trying to watch the number. Oh, 0 minutes. There it goes. I wonder why it doesn't just stop. I wonder if it goes to a certain number. What if it goes to 500?
This tape had a lot of not so important scenes.
Yeah.